That's because this song is called Alice's Restaurant.
Woo!
It's about Alice and the restaurant. But Alice's Restaurant was never the name of the restaurant. It was always just the name of the song. And I guess that's why I still call the song Alice's Restaurant.
Seven, eight.
years of the approach, the getaway, the northwest corner, the southwest corner. That's not to mention the aerial photography. Then it was after the ordeal, we went back to the jail. Obi said he was going to put us in the cell. He said, kid, I'm going to put you in the cell. Give me your wallet and your belt. And I said, Obi, I can understand you're wanting my wallet, so I don't have any money to spend in the cell. What do you want the belt for? He said, kid, we don't want any hands. I said, Obi, did you think I was going to hang myself for littering? Obi said he was making sure, and friends, Obi was, because he took out the toilet seat so I couldn't hit myself over the head and drown. Took out the toilet paper so I couldn't bend the bars, roll the toilet paper out the window, slide down the roll, have to escape and get away. Obi was making sure, all right, and it was about 4 or 5 hours later that Alice, remember Alice? This is still the song about Alice. She come by, and with a few nasty words to Obi on the side, she bailed us out of jail, and we went back to the church. Had another Thanksgiving dinner that couldn't be beat. Went to sleep and didn't get up until the next morning, when we all had to go to court. We walked in, sat down. Obi come in with the 27 8x10 color glossy pictures with the circles and arrows and a paragraph on the back of each one, explaining what each one was to be used as evidence against us. He sat down. A man come in. He said, all rise. And we stood up. And Obi stood up with the 27 8x10 color glossy pictures, and the judge walked in and sat down with a CNI dog. He sat down, we sat down. Obi looked at the CNI dog, and then at the 27 8x10 color glossy pictures, and looked at the CNI dog. And Obi began to cry, because Obi came to the realization that this was a typical case of American blind justice, and there was no way the judge was going to look at the 27 8x10. We was fined $25 each, and we had to pick up the garbage in the snow. But of course, that's not what I came to talk about so much, just thought I'd mention it. Tonight I thought I'd talk a little bit about the draft, and for those that wasn't there or don't know or can't remember, back in those days we used to have a thing called the Selective Service System, which meant that when you was a guy and you turned 18, you had to register with the Selective Service so that you could select some kind of service that might be of interest to you. If your choice was none of the above, they would help you by making a selection for you. And to do that, they had buildings all across America. We had to go in, get injected, inspected, detected, infected, neglected, and selected. And I remember I had to go in there one morning a long time ago for my physical examination. So I got good and drunk the night before, because I wanted to feel my best when I went in that morning. I mean, I wanted to feel like, I wanted to be like the old American kid. And when I went in that morning, I was hung down, I was brung down, I was hung up, I was all kinds of mean, nasty, ugly things. I walked in, I sat down. They gave me a piece of paper, said, kid, see the psychiatrist in room 604. I went in there. I said, shrink, I want to kill. I want to kill. I want to see blood, gore, guts, veins in the teeth, deep, dead, burned bodies. I mean, kill, kill. And I started jumping up and down, yelling, kill, kill. And he started jumping up and down with me. And we was both jumping up and down, yelling, kill, 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 kill. Till the sergeant come over, pinned the bell on me, set me down the hall saying, you're our boy. I didn't feel real good about it. till I come to see the very last man. I walked up, I said, what do you want to see me about? He said, kid, we only have one more question. Have you ever been arrested? I told him the story of the Alice's restaurant last week with the fire party, heard me full orchestration, all kinds of phenomena. He stopped me there. He said, kid, did you go to court? And I told him the story of the 2780x10 covered house he printed with the circles and arrows. And he stopped me again. He said, kid, I want you to go over and sit down on that bench that says Group W. I went over there. Group W is where they used to put you if you might not have been moral enough to join the army after committing your special crime. There was all kinds of mean, nasty, ugly looking people on the bench next to me. When they were mean, nasty, ugly, horrible, kind of guys.
There was mother rapers and father stabbers and there was Mother Rapers sitting there on the bench next to me. Like I said, these
were mean, nasty, ugly, horrible, pretty kind of guys. And the meanest, ugliest, nastiest one, the meanest Father Raper of them all, was coming over to me, sat down next to me, and said, kid, what'd you get? I said, I didn't get nothing. I had to pay $25 and pick up the garbage. He said, kid, what was you arrested for? I said, lettering. Give me the hairy eyeball and all kinds of stuff. Come on, so they create a nuisance. And then they all come back and shook my hand. And we had a great time on the bench talking about crime, mother stabbing, father raping, moving, smoking cigarettes, and all kinds of stuff. Having a good time. Till the sergeant come over. He had some paper in his hand. He held it up. He went, get the paper.
Maybe two of them trying to get married in parts of Kentucky or so.
maybe 3, or maybe 50, or maybe 50,000 people stop whatever they're doing, singing a few bars to the old song. Be worth collecting then. Not only that, you get a song with that many people singing, even the people collecting might start joining in. And when you get a song that's worth joining in on, no matter what side of the aisle you're on, or who you are, or what your story is, it becomes what we used to call a movement.
Woo!
Now, one of these days, somebody's gonna write a song like that. And it's not this one. Every generation needs their own songs. But while we're waiting for that one to get wrote, we can practice on the one we got. Not all that hard. Some of you even know it. I'm just trying to remember. You can't get anything you want at Alice's restaurant. You can't get anything you want at Alice's restaurant. Walk right in.
Alice's restaurant.
Seriously sucked. You can't start singing loud just at the end or something.